Everybody, welcome back. I hope you're doing really well. It's been a long time since I've sat down and filmed anything. Life has been a little bit interesting recently. Got my heart broken, which is funny, but it isn't funny, but it is kind of funny, but it isn't. But anyway, so yeah, I'm back. I'm feeling good. I've had some time to kind of recharge, feel all the things, and now I'm good. I'm going up to London in a little bit, so I'm just going to do my makeup really quick and have a little catch up with you lot, and then yeah. I hope you're back to doing normal videos kind of soonish, but I felt like I just wanted to do something chill to kind of ease me back into it. So I'm going to talk through the products while I do them because I kind of lose my flow of where I'm talking and stuff, so I will put everything in the description box. But yeah, go. So I'm going to zoom you in, I'm going to start with my skin, and then we'll have a catch up. I'm just filming in like natural light today. I'm just sitting in my room. I don't know, I didn't feel like being, I don't want to be so showbiz today. Weird how much I like miss sitting down filming. Like I always just feel like I'm just talking to my friends. Like, oh yeah, how are we all? How's things? Good, I hope. Yeah, I don't really know where to start. Of really good things and some not so good things. I feel like shit, like the best thing for me is always to just throw myself into work. Being creative and art and stuff has always kind of saved me. I know it's very cheesy, but I think for most people who love art and stuff, it kind of does end up being like sort of your salvation a little bit. I think any days that I felt down, like just going to the studio and just like tattooing people and meeting people and just talking to people, it just, I don't know, it just boosts you so much. Just a lot of you I think have gathered. Me and Luke aren't together anymore. I'm obviously not gonna like go into detail. I don't think you'd even want the detail. Like it's a lot. I've been kind of dealing with that and all the things that come with that. Very sudden, very unexpected, weird. Kind of just dealing with everything kind of comes with that situation. We've both always been very independent people. I don't feel like a complete loss, you know, I've still got all this amazing stuff going on and people around me are like so amazing. Like my family and my friends have just been like the best thing ever. I think the weirdest thing for me is like he literally was my best friend, so we've been together since we were 17, so it's like such a long time to grow up with someone. And yeah, we were literally best friends, so I don't know, that's been the weirdest thing for me, is kind of just losing that. I don't know, it almost kind of feels like that person doesn't exist anymore, and it's almost like in a weird way a kind of like grieving process is how I've kind of felt it. It feels very similar to like grief that I've felt before, and that he's not who he was and he's maybe not who I thought he was as well, which is fucking hard to like deal with. Kind of felt every emotion possible the last month. But yeah, like I say, it was very sudden. Like for me, it wasn't what I was expecting, it wasn't necessarily what I wanted. Yeah, I think I'm kind of coming out the other side of it and I'm starting to kind of see things as they actually are now. The kind of like anger has gone and real like deep sadness has gone. I think I'm just starting to see things for what they are. From a situation knowing that you literally couldn't have done any more is actually kind of a peaceful feeling in a weird way. Like as hard as it's been, I know that I've been so patient and I've honestly really tried. I feel like actually in a way I've almost kind of surprised myself, and I think I've been a lot stronger. I've always known I'm quite a strong person, but I think I've really like, I don't know, I've kind of excelled myself this time. Situations where I probably should have like fucking lost my head, I've managed to not do, which I can definitely recommend not doing, because it does feel better when you get out the other side and you know that you haven't, I don't know, lost your head. I feel like I've done everything I could. I feel pretty peaceful about the situation now, you know. Things happen. Like I say, we were together for such a long time. We were together since we were 17, so the amount that you change between then and now, like, we've always really grown together. Like, it's definitely not one of those things where you look back and think like, oh my god, there were so many red flags and this. Like, we had such a beautiful relationship. I'll always feel that way. Again, kind of nice to actually look back on something and be like, well, do you know what, it is what it is, and what happened. Actually had really good times and we really did love each other, and whatever happened in the end happened. and what more, I don't know, what more can you really do from that? Like, I know he did fucking hurt me, and he was, like, massively disrespectful to me, like, towards the end, which is why I kind of just had to put things to bed and kind of just move forward from it, because it just wasn't, it wasn't good, and it wasn't something that I wanted, really, in the end. Like, all of that, like, I wouldn't sit here and say, like, a bad word about him. I think from, like, past experiences, for me, like, I just don't like to hold on to that feeling. Like, for me, it's really heavy to kind of carry around, like, that anger and not, like, hatred. I don't think I would ever hate anyone, but just that kind of real heaviness of, like, still feeling anger and still feeling like things are unfinished. Like, for me, I can't carry that around. Like, I have to just have things put to bed, and I have to kind of have the answers that I need and then just move on. I just don't feel the need to kind of, like, drag him, and, like, I really could, to be honest, get anything out of doing that. I've kind of felt it in the past where you're like, all I want to do is make everyone know what this person's done to me, and you don't feel any better. You're just dragging yourself through the situation, like, a million times. Yeah, this time I was kind of like, I don't want to do that. I just want to move on, and I want to just put that to bed. Like, so, like, I don't have anything bad to say about him. I wouldn't, because I think when you've spent that much of your life with someone, like, I don't want to just think about that part. Actually, I would say it's more for me than anything. It's more just for me to not carry that feeling around and keep, like, kind of reliving everything. You know, I have to let go of it for myself. Weird. It's very strange when you kind of feel like you're really chill in your life. Like, everything felt very settled. Everything was really good. Like, there was literally no problems. Everything was really, really good. Like, we had such a good relationship. Everything was so chill. We really, like, understood each other. He was very supportive of me and very, like, proud of everything I did and stuff. And but yeah, it's kind of that thing, isn't it? When you feel comfortable, sometimes you need something to happen to kind of push you out of that, like, really comfortable, safe point. And you just have to see it in, like, a good way, I guess. Which is what I mean. Like, I obviously wasn't ready to, like, talk about anything really until, like, I do now, where I'm kind of just, like, out of it, and I'm like, oh, do you know what? Actually, I want to show you their true colors. Like, just let them. That, like, if someone is literally showing you who they are, like, don't try and just be like, oh no, but, like, they are a good person. Like, they're literally trying to show you who they are. So I'd rather see that now, is what I'm saying, rather than, like, further down the line, you know, when you got, like, a kid and a mortgage and shit. I don't want it then, you know. I'd rather have it now. Like, as much as it's hurt, for sure, it's fucking hurt. And anything else to say about it, to be fair, I kind of don't really want to talk about it again, which is why I sort of wanted to sit down and just say, like, things are fine. Like, I don't feel the need to be like, oh my god, I fucking hate him. Like, I don't feel like that at all. I've kind of had my time to process everything. Like, I felt angry, I felt really sad, I felt kind of lonely, and yeah, I think I've kind of learned to just feel things and not be so like, oh my god, I can't be upset, I need to, like, distract myself. Like, I feel like I've kind of gotten over things so much quicker because I've allowed my body to, like, feel everything so strongly, rather than, like, just pushing it away and pretending that it's not there. It's gonna come back and bite you a bit stronger if you kind of pretend that it isn't there. So yeah, I've been weeping, I've been sleeping, I've been chilling out, and yeah, I feel good, I feel much better. So yeah, that's kind of that. Like I was saying, when all of this first happened, like, it was very, very raw. We actually shot my third collection with Stacks, and Anna, bless her, who owns Stacks, she's just, like, an absolute angel. She's literally, like, become my second mum. I love her so much. She was like, oh my god, are you sure? Like, are you sure you want to do this? Are you okay? And I was like, this is the best thing for me right now, is just to kind of throw myself into something. Like, I need this so much. Just put my energy into something completely different. And yeah, we were, like, outside all day on Dalston High Street, the place of hopes and dreams. It was really fun. It was, like, really different to any of the other shoots that we've done. I'm wearing some of the new bits in my ears today, which is so cool. Like, wearing your own jewellery is just always the most, like, insane feeling in the world. I love it so much. It was honestly, like, probably the coldest I've ever been in my life. In, like, some of the pictures, like, my nose was running, and, like, they were running in to, like, pat my nose. I was like, oh, maybe we should go home. It was so much fun. I love the collection so much. It's, like, a little bit different, because obviously we'd done, like, the first two, which were more kind of safe sort of mixture of like fine jewellery, more kind of everyday pieces. All of mine like up here, I never take these out, these are from like the first collection. Like fine metals, so it's a little bit more expensive. And then yeah, when it came to like a third collection, I was kind of like, I don't know what to do. This collection, we were like, we want to just do something really fun. Like it's a lot more affordable, it's a lot more fun. I like a mixture of like fun things, some more like everyday things. So yeah, I'm very proud of that collection. I really love that. In general, life has been like pretty crazy. Actually, the week before I came home and everything ended up happening with Luca, I shot like the biggest thing that I've ever shot in my life, career, whatever. It was fucking amazing, and I feel like it kind of got overshadowed by everything that happened when I got home, but it was so amazing. And I think it will be about, you'll see in like, I think it's January, and the next one I think is a little bit later in the year, maybe like May. But yeah, it's really cool. It's not a product with my, it's not like a collaboration, it's not a product. It was me kind of more of like a modelling job for something big. But yeah, it was literally like insane, like the biggest thing I've ever done. And yeah, something that like I'm really proud of. So that's really exciting. So yeah, I feel like there's always like a lot of exciting things going on and a lot of things to kind of like refocus my energy on, which I feel really so grateful for. Like I don't know what I would do. Anyway, I know it's obviously horrible and I kind of wish that none of this had happened and things were still chill, but maybe it was necessary, and it's probably one of those things that you look back and think, actually, like I know exactly why that needed to happen. Thing is, like I'm still doing everything that I was doing, like nothing's really massively changed other than, like I said, where we were so close and we spent so much time together and I feel like we'd really grown up together. It just feels like I've kind of lost a best friend, which is fucking horrible, and it does like really hurt. Like it's happened at a time where I feel happy enough in myself and I know who I am enough to feel confident on my own. Because that is something that I've kind of worried about, where I've always been like subconsciously, like I've never kind of thought about it, but I've always been in a relationship, and I think part of me was like, wow, what if I actually don't know how to be on my own? But yeah, I think even if this had happened this time last year, maybe I wouldn't have been as strong on my own. But I feel like it's happened at a time where like I'm so happy with work and I love what I do, and yeah, like everything that I was gonna do, I'm still gonna do. I still love my job, I'm so grateful, I have the best family and friends, like literally that I could ever ask for. I'm still gonna move out, I'm still gonna buy somewhere on my own. I feel like I've accepted there's going to be days that I'm going to be a bit like, eh, that's fine. And I don't feel like I'm embarrassed about that. But there's such a thing about when you break up with someone that is so like, oh my god, I'm fine, I'm fucking fine, I'm going out, I'm enjoying myself. That's cool, that's great. But if you're not, also fine. Like you kind of almost feel like embarrassed. You're like, oh my god, why am I upset? But obviously, like, you've been with someone for that long. A bit really, like, it's just breaking habits and little things. Like when you hear things and you're like, oh, I want to tell them. And then you're like, oh, I can't tell them. It's good. It's nearly Christmas. I fucking hate Christmas anyway, but I'm trying to be festive because everyone is peer pressuring me. So I'm trying. Also, the pink hair is going next week. She's not served me well. It's been a turbulent time, you know? I want to just look back at pictures and be like, that was the pink hair time. God rest her soul, I don't want to do it anymore. It's very like little psychological things for me. I'm like, well, if I change my hair, like I'll feel different, which I know I won't. I'm fully aware that I won't, but I'm gonna keep it short. I love my hair short, but I'm just gonna change the color a little bit just to give me a kind of new lease of life. That's it. I don't think there's anything else to talk about. I'm gonna go up to London now. I'm going to an exhibition with my mum, which is so cute, and I'm really excited. Thank you for listening to me just ramble on. I felt like it was a bit weird to just go straight back into another video and kind of not sort of explain what's going on, because a lot of people obviously I think have gathered things. I obviously deleted all the pictures off my Instagram, the first thing to do, the most important thing to do. I mean, people know what's going on, don't they? So I feel like it makes more sense to just address it and get everything out there, and then you can kind of move on. Generally things are very positive. I'm very happy, I'm very excited about the future. I feel so happy to feel like creative again, and I'm really enjoying like reading again. I'm really enjoying like drawing, just like for fun, and kind of just like painting and just all the things that I feel like I'd kind of lost a little bit. I hope you have a lovely rest of the day wherever you are, and I will see you all very soon. Oh, I didn't show you my makeup. Should we do that? Maybe we'll do that. Sorry, I've been gone a little while. Not very interesting, but this is kind of just what I do like every day now, like when I'm just going to work. I didn't do my eyebrows. Well, they're fine, I don't care. Very simple, very quick everyday makeup. Have a lovely rest of the day and I will see you all very soon. Love you.